males and literacy, two things that are not commonly associated together. But it's important that we talk about black males and literacy because there's some things that you may not know. So there's a researcher out there named Brozo who has a book called Reading Don't Fix No Chevys that's all about getting males of color involved and engaged in reading. Brozo specifically talks about that males enjoy reading material where there's characters that actually do something, right? So boys are not always interested in some of the things that we would assume. Boys enjoy reading stories where the characters are doing something, right? So boys enjoy reading comic books where there's a hero, it's well-defined. Boys enjoy reading stories in either even magazines when there's men playing sports or people playing sports. But boys often enjoy reading stories where there's a female lead character as long as she's doing something that they find interesting. So yes, boys like to read all different types of things, but not necessarily the type of books that are given to them in K-12 education. So what are some of the things that boys like to read? Well, boys especially like reading expository texts. Expository texts are texts where there's just facts. There's not a lot of interpretation. So this book right here, I'll post a link to it here. For example, books about sharks, boys and girls enjoy reading that. But when there's a book where there's a shark, what do sharks look like? What do sharks do? Where they live? Those are the type of things that boys especially like reading. So Ernest Morrell and Ernest Tate also talk about books that black males like to read are books that have black male characters or characters that deal with culture or cultural identity, right? That's important to black males. So one of my favorite books related to that is this book here, We Are the Ship. This is written by Kadir Nelson. Kadir Nelson was a gentleman who was an artist that was commissioned to do the artwork for the Negro League Baseball Museum. And he wound up finding so much information about that, about the Negro Leagues, that he decided to write a book. So Kadir Nelson is an artist that became a writer because of what he drew. So to give you a really good example, here's one. I'll also post this so it's easier to see. It's a really good example. Look at that art. Look at that artwork and that detail. He spends a lot of time making sure that he gets things right. So it's not just the action, it's the interest and the subject matter. And lastly, this one is one that I especially like. This is from the sixth chapter that he calls the sixth inning. It's about Latin America, baseball, and paradise. Latin America, baseball, and paradise. I especially like this chapter because it has Negro League baseball players going to Cuba, right, and enjoying a Latin environment, and there's some wonderful stunning pictures of that. But it also has the culture of men and manhood doing guy stuff, right, playing baseball, after the games, meeting girls, having a good time, riding together in a bus to and from the different baseball matches. That's a story that young boys really enjoy because it's not necessarily that it's just culture, but it's also gender. And that's something that I've seen work wonders for getting young black males engaged in reading.